permafrost, as the name suggests, refers to types of ground that stay frozen year-round. There's many types of it, and it can be found in many places, even beneath the ocean. And scientists often look to it as a measuring tool to gauge how much and how fast the Earth may be warming. One of the more temperature-sensitive types of permafrost is what's known as Yadoma permafrost. It's made up of frozen sand and silt deposits laced through with large, complicated ice structures. And indeed, scientists have been seeing big changes in it, specifically the areas of it in Siberia. Yadoma permafrost was formed during the Pleistocene period, what we would call the last ice age, that began some 2 million years ago. Although a lot of the Earth's surface was covered with glaciers, Yadoma's distinctive structure formed on land that didn't have glaciers. What you had was very cold grassland, steppes. Water would enter crevices in the ground during seasonal warm periods, freezing and refreezing over the course of thousands of years, to form Yadoma's distinctive ice wedges, which would then be buried, along with dead, frozen plants, the animals that ate those plants, the animals that ate those animals, beneath accumulating layers of sand and silt as the millennia rolled on. Besides containing an enormous amount of ice, Yadoma permafrost contains an enormous amount of organic carbon. Now, the ice structures laced through Yadoma render it particularly susceptible to quick thawing. As temperatures tick up and these ice wedges begin to melt, the ground surrounding them begins to subside, exposing not only yet more ice, but also ancient layers of dead plants and animals frozen up to now, and these begin to decompose. Microbes go to work releasing carbon dioxide and methane, potent greenhouse gases, which only adds to the climate warming problem and can contribute to even more thawing of the permafrost. And the cycle continues. But as the Yadoma permafrost degrades and the landscape changes, the pace of this cycle and its impact on the local ecosystem and the global climate are likely to increase.